Hello everyone, welcome back to another video. Today we're going to be listening to another ghost song. Now, I've been discovering a few of their songs recently. Today we're going to be listening to Darkness at the Heart of My Love. If you haven't heard it, I'll have a link in the description, but let's get straight into it. Now, I've been discovering a few of their songs, and the last one I heard, which was Hyserion, I believe, was completely different style to what I was expecting. And again, this seems to be a completely different style. Okay. Now, is this going to be more towards the sort of acoustic elements and the soft piece? I think it could be. Oh, okay. Little, some click sounds. I feel like this one might throw me off a bit compared to what I was expecting as well. Really, some quite good soft vocals here. Ooh. Wow, that's quite a powerful jump into this bit. And wow, okay, this sounds like it's going to be quite an epic, sort of beautiful piece. Not what I was expecting, but I'm quite pleasantly surprised as well. I feel like Ghost is going to be one that keeps throwing me off, because I keep hearing songs that just I wouldn't expect by them. But this sounds really quite a beautiful piece so far. And he's got really good vocals. And almost quite a signature vocal sound, I'd say, with his voice. Yeah. I feel like once people get into this song and like the crowd singing it live, this would sound quite epic and quite amazing, honestly. Yeah, this is honestly quite... Okay, that sounds like it's going into a solo. So before that starts, yeah, just to make some notes, discovering more recently, as I said, but I knew a few of their like really popular ones like Square Hammer and a few that are similar to that. But yeah, honestly, the ones I've been discovering recently are all really quite varied styles, not the same as the ones that I'd heard previously. So it's really quite good to hear how different their styles can be. Complete different piece. It's like very much stripped back, very sort of acoustic. There is obviously some like electric guitar in there as well, but like it feels much more acoustic and much more I don't know how to describe it. It's like vocal orientated, but there's like some drums and stuff. It feels very much a stripped back piece. The crowd is going to be singing along a lot too as well, and I'm trying to think how best to describe it. I don't think ambient is the right word, but I think it's got like quite an atmosphere around the song. I don't know how to describe it. It's like it's really quite a weird feeling I'm getting from this one, like in a good way. Like it's such an amazing piece almost. So that's the best way I can think to describe it. But yeah, it just sounds like it's gonna be a really epic live song that everyone's gonna be wanting to sing along to, or at least that's what I think so far. But yeah, let's see what the rest of it has to offer, because yeah, they keep throwing me off. But in the best way, like songs that I wouldn't expect. Okay. The click's coming back in. Is that even an acoustic? Is that an acoustic guitar? Is that like, it almost sounds like a ukulele, unless it's like the really high notes on the guitar. I could be completely wrong, but that's what it's sounding like to me. Yeah, this sounds somehow this is such, feels really catchy. I've noticed this bit, this one, this chorus was more stripped back as well before building back up into this bit. Yeah, I feel like live, this is probably an amazing song to hear. Yeah, this is, but I don't know, it just brings a smile to my face. I don't know why, I'm just really quite enjoying this one. And it's, I guess I'm a bit lost for words. It's got like a whole atmosphere around this song that's really quite cool, but it's not the typical song I would listen to either, so it's really quite interesting. Okay, I think it's fading. The song's fading out here. Yeah, okay. Yeah, as I said, that feels like such an epic piece, and I'm kind of lost for words and how to actually describe it. It just feels like an sort of epic piece that the whole crowd can sing along to, and surprisingly catchy despite it being a more stripped back song, and that they don't tend to be as catchy for me, but this one kind of had me on the hook, I won't lie. I guess it's kind of like a beautiful masterpiece in a way. Like, I guess that's the best way you could describe it. Very surprisingly really enjoyed that one, because as I said, I listen to completely different style normally. I'm much towards the metalcore side of things, so really quite interesting hearing a song like this that's really, I'm quite taken a like to straight away. Like, that's normally a good sign for a slower, more acoustic song for me, that if it's that good that I just can't help but like it straight away. Quite enjoying discovering more ghost songs, and I'm discovering a lot of new bands that people are suggesting me, so thank you for the suggestions. But yeah, if you've got any more ghost songs, let me know. I'm wanting to discover more. They keep throwing spanners in the works that keep throwing me off, and I'm not sure what to expect. But yeah, let me know what you think in the comments. Thank you for watching, everyone, and I'll see all of you in the next one.